Now in Vegas talk, this morning's draw was a push. Team North America had a win, a loss, and a tie. The world team, well, they were lucky to escape all even. This afternoon, though, it's not about the luck, but rather skill. It's the singles competition. And the world's best curlers are all set to show off their talents. Draw 5 is next, here at the Continental Cup. The Colorado River, the wonderful Hoover Dam, about a half hour's drive south of Las Vegas, right on the border, Nevada and Arizona. This morning was team play to get the second day of the Continental Cup underway. And Jennifer Jones, who struggled badly, she and the team on day one, losing to Eve Muirhead, were right on the game and heading off to Sochi, looking very good here. Look at this great come around against Margareta Sigfridsson, who the last 2 years has won the silver medal at the Women's Worlds. And Jones would go on to beat the Swedish representative in Sochi. But with that push, Rachel Holman picking up a half point. Team North America with still the 3-point lead, 7.5 to 4.5 on the race to 30 and a half points to claim the Continental Cup. So what's ahead? Well, this morning we had those team games. Today it's singles matches, 6 points available. And then 10 p.m. tonight, we're back with you for more team play. As on this Friday afternoon, we say hello, Canada. Welcome back to the Orleans Arena and our continuing coverage of the Continental Cup. Linda Russ alongside. I love him. I love the singles. I know. Here's what the singles is all about. It's maybe called singles, but it is really a team game because everyone is involved. There are the 6 different shots, and then you can be awarded 0 to 5 in terms of points. 2 members of your team will have to throw at least 2 of those shots, meaning the other 2 will play 1 of those shots. All right, Linda, advantage to anybody going into singles play?
Well, a lot of this contest is about ice reading and apply the appropriate weight in those 3 takeout shots. So the advantage goes to the teams that are playing well. Good example, Jennifer Jones, she has the feel of this ice.
All right, what about planning if you're trying to figure out who should play what shots?
A lot of strategy there for sure. Like if you're a Jill officer, you're probably not playing the draw. You're playing the double, the run back, something with a lot of speed control. You're going to see Don McCune or Jennifer Jones, for instance, throw the soft shots because that's their specialty.
It's the great singles afternoon here in Las Vegas at the Continental Cup.
World Financial Group Continental Cup is brought to you by World Financial Group, creating a better tomorrow for families today. WFG. Financial Group Continental Cup is brought to you by M&M Meat Shops, frozen food at its best, by Capital One, what's in your wallet, and by Purex Bathroom Tissue. Purex, 90 years of pure comfort.
So it's the singles competition on this Friday afternoon. There you see John Schuster and the American representatives out of Duluth, Minnesota. David Murdoch, who will represent Great Britain. So here on She Day are the women's matchups. It'll be Team Muirhead against Jennifer Jones. Make a note that, as Russ suggested, Jennifer Jones will throw the draw to the button and the draw to the fort, the softer shots being played by the skip. On Sheet B, Margareta Sigfridsson against Rachel Holman. And Rachel will try to gather herself up after missing a last rock takeout to split the points with Fujisawa of Japan. And then it is Satsuki Fujisawa on sheet C as she plays Erica Brown. And the draw to the button again. You see the skips. Brown playing the softer shots, the draw to the button, and the last, the draw to the fort. So the first shot is draw the button. And a key to this, Linda, would be what?
Well, it's obvious you're trying to hit the button. You get 5 points if you do just that. So it's trying to find the place to put the room to get to that spot. Remember on this ice, it goes a little straight at first. You want to get to that button because then it goes down 4 foot is four, 8 foot is three, 12 foot is two, and anywhere in the free guard zone is just one.
And Jennifer Jones will pick the stone that she needs to get us underway. We'll do all the Team North America right across the sheet, and then the world will have their chance.
What do you think, guys?
This is where stopwatches do come into play. If you have them and you're used to using them, you can time, for example, Jennifer's rock if you're the opposition or on the other sheets, because we have great consistency right across the three sheets of ice. You can learn from this draw.
So Jennifer Jones gets us underway. The singles competition, it's the draw to the button.
Line good.
Peyton Laws, you can hear her calling line.
Line straight.
Another great advantage is the two brushers. In this case, Don McEwen and Jill Officer, great judges and very powerful if they need it.
So right now in the free guard zone, that's 1 point. Trying to take it as much as they can. That's 2 points. A little further, ladies. That's three. That's four. Grab the button, and that's five.
Yeah, pretty close to normal for Dawn up here.
Is it us?
So over to sheet B now, and it'll be Rachel Holman.
You just saw the little signal. Rachel does throw that straighter rock. So Jennifer took out into the 12 foot. Yes, this is a different sheet of ice, but it is the way she throws.
Is it ever? And I would suggest if she was on your outturn, she'd dig even less ice than edge of the eights. But Rachel knows it.
Emma Miskew putting the brush down, Russ, just on the edge of the eight foot.
Take a look. Mine's really good.
It also means on this particular throw, being in a little bit, you won't have that run as much. This could curl quite a bit coming into the four.
Kirby Asik, Weagle trying to hold the line. You can hear the crowd now trying to hold the line with them. Got the 1 point, need a little bit more to grab two, and she's going to come up light. And so that will be a single point.
I guess. Felt pretty good.
Just a hair inside that path, caught the noose, but there were two practices, but that's it. So it's really first and throw.
It'll be Erica Brown now. She will represent the U.S. in Sochi.
That's pretty good.
Out of the Madison, Wisconsin Curling Club. Going to make a third appearance at the Olympics.
Lots of room. Give it a pull.
And Swiss Helm. Jessica Schultz, the front end. Debbie McCormick, the world champion of 2003, needs to find some breaks here. Hold on for four. And she does. So do you go to school if you're Team World? On those, do you think, Linda?
I think you absolutely do, especially the speed. Now, releases are a little different, so the amount of ice you take is a little different. But everybody, don't forget the men come out later, will watch these shots very carefully and see what they can learn.
Now it is the world's turn, and we'll stay there on sheet C. That'll be the skip from Kurosawa. This is Satsuki Fujisawa. Saw earlier today, Russ, she does have the draw weight. Up weight shots maybe fail her a little bit, and line calling bothers them, but from a purely delivery point, you say that they can throw it as well as anyone.
Oh, no question. I think it's going to show up in the singles competition, because there's not a lot of strategy here. You've got to execute.
There's four, and now about five. So early advantage in game, on the game, on the sheet C, to Team World. Now to sheet B. Margareta Sigfridsson.
Now, this is interesting. It is all skips playing all draws in these first three games, but she throws lead, of course, and skip for her team.
Back to what we talked about in during the game against Jennifer Jones, where the last rock thrower, Maria, just really struggled with draw weight, and that's probably why she's not electing to play this shot.
Christina Bertram on the left, Maria Vennerstrom. Maria Pritz managing the house. That's good for two. That's good for three. That's good for four. And that's really good. That's good for five. So a big head start for Team World there as Rachel Holman only managed a single point with her draw. So 5-1 there. On sheet A, we saw Jennifer Jones make the draw to the button. She put it right on the pinhole for five. Eve Muirhead, reigning women's world champion and one of the favorites. She'll represent Great Britain. 23-year-old from Perth. Anna Sloan.
Needs to curl.
Managing the house. Vicky Claire Hamilton on the brush. They hit over. There's three and enough. Not quite. The umpire checks.
Just a bite of the four.
Or just grabbed it. Just grabbed the 4 foot for four.
There's a case pick where they tried really too hard to let it curl to get to the button. They had to brush that sooner for speed, and they almost didn't get it in the 4 foot.
So next up, it is the run through.
Well, you have a stone position just in front of the rings. You have to move that onto the one in the house. If you stick it right there and it sits in the button area, you get 5 points. If the rock rolls a little bit to the 4 foot, you still get the good 4 points. The further it rolls, the points go down. 3 in the 8 foot, 2 in the 12 foot. And if you have to get the raised, the one in the house out, then you get a point if your rock does roll out.
David Hay on the left, he's the captain of Team World, the 91 world champion. Pia Lindholm, who runs the Swedish national program, a three-time world champion. His team got off to a great start. They lead in two, trail by just a single in one. So it'll be the world to begin, and it is Vicky Adams that will get us underway. Adams, the 24-year-old, throws the second stones from your head out of Edinburgh. Sloan, Claire Hamilton have got her right out of the hand. Bang it back and bangs it by, so they couldn't hold the line.
That was one of those where they took very tight ice, and I think they expected maybe a little more weight, even maybe more of that in-out of motion we've talked about with releases. That one curled.
Same facial expression at both ends.
Maria Pritz. She throws the fourth stones for Margaret and Sigfridsson. Struggled badly today against Jennifer Jones.
This one's also curling.
And she'll also run it by. So it's been a struggle so far for Team World.
Hey, Brahmania.
You know, it's interesting because I talked about the fact with the three takeout shots that will play over this contest, you could play a variety of weights. You could play that with any kind of quiet weight as long as you get the one out in the house. The advantage of the tight broom is you throw the up weight and you do keep it straight. Both of those players had too much curl, maybe got the rock started a bit.
But good point, a softer weight, when you do, if you make contact with the object rock, you have a much better chance of hanging around.
Emmy Shimizu throws the lead stones for the Fujisawa team from Kurosawa. And again, no points. So this is a great opportunity for Team North America as the world fails to score anything.
They're getting some sympathy anyways from the person holding up the score.
So we'll remain on sheet C. And she is a world champion. Debbie McCormick throwing the third stones for Erica Brown, won her world championship in Winnipeg in 2003.
Yes! Yes! Hurry!
Pretty soft weight here.
Yes! Come on!
Jessica Schultz and Swiss Help. Got to hold it. Watch that center line. Going to touch anything, and no, will not. So it remains 5-4. Team World leading there after two shots.
Well, we certainly know where the broom will be for this team. Almost in the middle of the stone, they're trying to hit in front of the house to drive back onto the one in the house.
Allison Kirby-Azik throwing the second. Yeah. Rachel Holman, the reigning Canadian champions out of the Ottawa Curling Club. Miscue, Weagle on the brush. Watch that center line, run it back. Oh, and sticks it. And oh, it spills a little too far. But the first point scored, and it's 3. Caitlin Laws, who throws the third stones for Jennifer Jones.
Real close.
Officer McEwen, center line. Got it? Got it? Oh, and it just curled at the last moment.
There's an example, Vic, just a fraction less weight than the skipper thought. They waited a hair too long for it to curl and away it went.
So Jones remains up. Only Rachel Holman and Allison Kremiasek's team managing to score points. The Rays, when we come back to Las Vegas. The men will be coming up right after the ladies have completed their singles competition. So we've completed 2 of the 6 required shots. And remember now, there are 6 matches, 3 women's matches, then the 3 men. Each is worth just 1 point in that race to 30 and a half for the Continental Cup. Coming up, it is the Rays.
So as opposed to playing this with takeout weight, you're trying to move a stone in front of the house into the circles. And once the stone is released, there's a great deal of communication needed to try and get it in the best spot. Perfect weight, perfect line, you get 5 because you raise it to the button. A little off angle is 4, 8 foot is 3, 12 foot is 2. The stone that gets 1 point has to move forward a little bit and stay in play.
And it'll again be Team North America that gets us underway. And from Team Jennifer Jones, their lead, Dawn McEwen. You like this call and having her play this?
Oh, for sure. Obviously, the free draw, the draw through the port would be her specialty, too. But this is just a heavy draw, and it's all line. And Jennifer's one of the best at knowing the line.
Jill Officer on the left. Caitlin Laws. Really hard, Jennifer Jones says. Really hard now. Got to try to hold the line here. Just bang it right on the schnoz and take it back. And, boy, it didn't have enough weight. Just grabs the top of the 12 for 2 points.
It's a bit of strategy too here, Vic, also, because you're better to be a little heavy, I think, and then the skip can kind of oversweep it, hit it thinner, take some speed off it. Once you're light, you're light.
Interesting, also going with the lead, Lisa Weagle from Rachel Holman's team, the reigning Canadian women's champion.
We're seeing a lot of curl right in the center of the ice. So Elisa Weagle, this team in the middle, Rachel Holman's team, have a little advantage because of their release, a little in-out release on most of their shots.
All on its own. They never laid a lick to it. 5. No, it'll be there for 4.
Stand by and shoot safe. And she'd see the umpires correct.
And again, it'll be the lead for Erica Brown's team out of Madison, Wisconsin, and Swiss Helm From what we've seen, everyone has had that same kind of thought process in terms of who they've had make their shots or try their shots. Gabby McCormick, Jessica Schultz on the brush, right to the nose. Hold it there now. That's two. And that will be for three.
Three points.
John B. Peyton Laws waiting the men to follow immediately.
Well,
24-year-old Neil Ichikawa. Not a lick from the front end at all. Two, three, sit, sit. That's Japanese for sit, and it will at the back edge of the eight.
Great example of what Russ was talking about, though. They managed it. They knew they shouldn't brush it because they needed some angle into the four-foot area, but still that little extra weight worked out for three points.
Exactly, and you can actually, if it is heavy, you could sweep that, hit it thinner, and take some weight off of it. That's the way to play it, I think.
They managed to hold the lead in that game. Christina Bertram, who throws the third stones for Margareta Sigfridsson out of Skellefteå, Sweden. Vennerström, that's four, that's five if it hangs on, and it does. After throwing the zero on the run through, that's back to back fives. 10-8 by a couple now over Rachel Holman through three of the six shots.
Different dynamic here, I think, you know, like Claire, the skipper, Eve Muirhead, plays her last shot in front of 5,000 people, but not, Claire doesn't, right? It's the only shot going on. The whole crowd's watching this particular shot. It's a little different.
It is Claire Hamilton. Three, four. How is that, skipper? She puts it on the lid for five. Claire Hamilton.
Guess the pressure didn't bother at all.
I don't think so. World champion, you know.
Next up, it's the hit and roll.
This is one of those things that actually the line call is critical. You have to play from the center line out. You can't play it with the other side. So you roll that one into the button. Really tough to do. You get the full 5 points. Roll it to the 4 foot four, 8 foot three, 12 foot two. And you have to get a little bit of a removal of the stone and roll for the single point. We see a lot of over curls on this shot, Vic.
Wonderful crowd on hand again, Linda, here at the Orleans Arena. Everyone has been so involved with this and watching all the draws. Russ, we've had great crowds morning, noon, and night.
Unbelievable. I've always felt, being a golfer, that the par on all these shots is a three out of five. If you could average three, which would be six shots, 18, a score of 18, and we've got Muirhead at nine up to three shots, right on par. Sigfridsson's actually at 10. It's good scores.
This shot could be played two ways, tight ice and big weight, which looks like what Anna is about to play, or you can take a little more ice and play the softer roll, maybe a little easier to actually get the angle into the button.
Anna Sloan throws the third stones for Eve Muirhead. Adams, Hamilton, down. Little late rushing. There it comes. Now where's this roll going? That's three. That's four. Where's she going? A little more. How about five?
That was a lovely throw. You could tell by on-off brushing. Very accurate throw.
My goodness, too. The tap to the button and the hit and roll to the button. It doesn't get any better than that.
And she beat the umpire's her win.
So Maria Vennerström, the 28-year-old, This team is the reigning European champion. They've won back-to-back silver medals at the Women's Worlds, including a year ago in Riga, Latvia. Right away, Schaefersen calling on Fritz and Bertrup for three. One more. A little more turn, maybe one more. Not quite. And four it is.
But they held that. I thought that might have been an overcurl. They did a great job holding it for Maria.
And she sees the umpires already.
You have to throw that almost normal weight like that one to get the right kick to get to the button.
Either that or it's very thin, and that's hard to judge.
Yep.
So it's Team Fujisawa from Kurosawa.
You know, that follows up a little bit what you talked about. She has that left shoulder go back, overreaches, and got inside on
just
that.
Started that early, didn't she?
So she picks up the single point for removing the stone.
Pretty tight ice here for Deb McCormick. You're taking about 4 inches of ice to make that half rock roll.
For Debbie, she was in Nagano in 98 with Lisa Schoenenberg and then Carrie Erickson in Salt Lake, Vancouver, where she went 2-7 and now heading off to Sochi as part of Erica Brown's team.
One.
And that'll be worth 1 point. So struggles for both teams on sheet C.
And sheet B, the umpires are ready.
Emma Miskew throws third rocks for Rachel Holman out of the Ottawa Curling Club. And we'll see this team, of course, at the Scotties. As they wear the Team Canada jersey in Montreal.
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Trevi Asik. There's three. Come on, ladies. There's four. Come on, ladies. Come on. Hold on for five. And that was a much needed 5 points to stay within touch of Margareta Sigfridsson.
She gave the umpires already.
Nine. They say they're ready.
Eve Muirhead and Team World scored five. Caitlin Lars.
Whoa. Whoa. Close. Yep. Whoa. Whoa. No.
No.
No. No. No. No. No.
Stay with it.
Now,
three.
Officer Jones, four. A little more. And just shy. It'll sit there for four.
A little bit of a tough break. If they brushed it a tiny bit earlier, that would have been rolling in.
So Muirhead and Team World leading there. The double takeout in the final shot of the day for the women will be through the port when we come back to Las Vegas. Thomas Olsrud and his team from Oslo, Norway will be on the ice in a matter of moments for the singles competition, but we'll see him tonight. Won the Olympic silver medal in Vancouver, looking forward to Sochi. He'll represent Norway there, goes against Brad Jacobs. A preview of a game at the Olympics tonight, 10 p.m. Eastern Time. Now they get a little more difficult, the double takeout, Linda.
Well, the key with this is you have to remove the two opposition stones. You have to play from the center line out as well. If you get rid of both stones and stay in the button area, you get the 5 points. Get them both out, roll to the 4'4", roll to the 8'3", 12'2". But you must remove both opposition stones to get the single point.
And as you expected and thought, Russ, you're going to call on somebody who throws them up weight, so it will be Jill Officer for Jennifer Jones.
Bring in the right hander for this one.
It's
She's plays so many of these shots, so she practices more of these shots. But I like with Jill, not only can she obviously throw the big weight, but watch the rotation. It's so easy to read.
Hard! Boy, right out of her hand, though, Dawn McEwen. Caitlin Laws. Now called off, and maybe that little bit of an early jump.
Sorry.
And they jumped the stone and straightened it out, and so it's 0 points.
And she's being the umpires already.
Have a miscue. Playing the third rocks for Rachel Holman.
Yeah. Close, yep.
Winning the Scotties a year ago and then a bronze medal at the Worlds. Kirby Azic, Weagle, what do you got? One and not enough.
No more.
Lisa, she just pointed that one a little bit. Just came over the top. The last second, you can see it just dart inside a hair.
Jessica Schultz, 29-year-old native of Anchorage, now makes her home in Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Come on, go, 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 go!
Bang. And then across the top.
No points.
We get a lot of zeros on this one. We've seen some curl on this ice. It makes it a little harder. You have to get both of them out of the house. You just can't tick them around. It's a tough shot.
It's a thinner double than it looks, and it's easy for me to say that because I don't know how, what people are thinking, but you can hit that extremely thin and stick your thrown rock. Probably a quarter rock would do it.
And so Chiaki Matsumura throws the second stones for team from Kurosawa. Went 5-6 at the Worlds last year in Riga, Latvia. One. And here she goes. Oh, my. A huge 5 points for Team World.
Oh, my.
Oh, my.
And she beat the players already.
How is a beauty?
Maria Prince throws the fourth stone for Margareta Sigfridsson. Bertram, Vennerstrom, brush, bang, and five! And with that, we know that they have
very tight ice on this one.
Ever.
Whoa.
Anna's out turn, though. It will run straighter.
Never. Okay.
And a little thin, and so no points there.
Okay, on sheet A, Team North America 11, and Team World 14.
So we have one shot remaining, and that is drawing through the port or through the hole.
Now on this ice, this is a little harder than it seems, and it seems to hang a long time on that corner guard. It has to, of course, get by the center guard to the button. If you can get through that board and make that draw, you get the full 5 points. If you get it through to the 4 foot, 4, 8 foot three, 12 foot two, and you have to get it past those two stones out in front for the single point.
Here in the Orleans Arena, Friday afternoon. This is the game still up for grabs here, as it's been a women's competition so far dominated by the World, and it was those 2 5-point shots by Sigfridsson's team and the Fujisawa team.
As Linda said, Eve Muirhead threw the opening rock quite a ways ago, so the ice will be straightening out a hair. She has to be careful not to keep it on that wide guard. They're leading here. They have to get this in the paint somewhere and put some pressure on Jones. Get through the port.
Whoa. Just clear.
Clear. Whoa.
Lane spade! Lane spade, just for wait.
Okay, Claire, you bend it now, bend it now.
Yep. And it's slowed.
Go.
Bend it now.
Go.
Bend it now. Bend it like your head.
Linjen är bra, inte så mycket
Sigfridsson.
Perfekt linje. Dra den på
helt era.
På tio. På tio. På tio.
På locket nu.
Jättebra linje.
That's a great finish for five more. The world picks up another point.
She's seen the umpire's parade.
And now the young skip, 22-year-old Satsuki Fujisawa. Big scrub here, got it by. Now even bigger scrub, they take it as far as they can. That's three, and that'll be all five. World has come storming back here, Linda.
They played it very well. Russ talked about the fact that a lot of these teams practice more. They don't have as many competitions they can access, particularly the Japanese team, for example. So they practice these sort of skills and get very good at it.
It's important.
Yeah, I think the advantage goes to North America with the seasoning, the ice reading, how to miss different weight controls, maybe a wee bit of strategy. But when it comes to sheer shot making, like you say, these teams throw a lot of rocks. Big scores here by all the world teams.
Hard line, gotta go! Hard line! Hard line!
Edgar Brown skidding it. There's two. There's three. There's four. And how about five?
Nice call, Debbie. Good sweep, guys.
So the world picks up the point.
Umpires are the sheet beat.
Rachel Holman.
Line's good. Little light. Line's good. Let it curl. Line's nice. Line's good.
Could have
asked. Let it bend a bit.
Weagle.
Let it bend. Fine.
Looks pretty good. There's two. Looks pretty good. There's three. Pretty good. Looks great. A big finish. Five. But not enough, as the world will pick up another point. 24-18. Remember, they were down by three coming in.
Line's good.
Line's good.
Got room. Line's good. All you.
All you.
Line's great.
Jill Officer. Don
Keep
McEwen.
Keep her coming. Hard.
A little more. And it will just grab the top for one.
1 point.
Let's go, guys.
Nice.
And so the world dominates here as they take the competition 19-12 here and pick up three big points. So the men will hop the boards and get ready. It'll be their turn. And the world has come back to tie in the race to 30.5. We're all even. It's the singles competition on day two. We are in Las Vegas at the Orleans Arena. The world women grab 3 points to tie. The men are up next when we come back to Las Vegas.
This is the Feather Room of Don Arden's Jubilee Theater here at the Bally Hotel. And eventually all of these feathers will be on the showgirls in a spectacular performance that involves music, singing, dance, and of course, at one point in time, they sink the Titanic, and eventually there's that grand finale when they all walk down the familiar staircase. This is the longest spectacular in Las Vegas. It's been running for 32 years. The first time a showgirl, however, made her appearance was 1958, and all the big stars had them. Remember the Rat Pack, Frank Sinatra, Sammy Davis Jr.? They all had the showgirls behind them, as I do now. Please welcome, this is Anne, and this is Sarah, part of the spectacular here at the Jubilee. Ladies, this is a pleasure.
We had Cece from Don Arden's Jubilee show. And going on there, Don Arden produced those shows from 1952 to 1994. Brad Jacobs trying to keep his concentration with Cece right there. We'll Cece the men when we come back.
World Financial Group Continental Cup is brought to you by Ford, proud partner of the Canadian Curling Association for over 20 years. World Financial Group Continental Cup is brought to you by Scotty's Facial Tissue. Scotty's, the perfect touch. By Tim Hortons, always fresh, always great tasting coffee. And by M&M Meat Shops, frozen food at its best.
So, have you ever been to Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario? Brian Fry with Tara joining us here at the Orleans. So here are the games within a game. Nicolazine against Brad Jacobs and the players who will play the six different shots. That's on sheet A. On sheet B, it'll be Thomas Holsrud against Jeff Stout. And interestingly enough, they're going to have Mark Nichols play the softer of the shots. The draw the button and draw the port. That's on sheet B. And on sheet C, David Murdoch goes against John Schuster, who will represent the U.S. at the Olympics. So we'll get it underway with drawing the button. And here it is.
It's the same as we talked about before, and that line is really critical. And if you get a little too wide, it won't come into that button area, but that's worth 5 if you can get into that area. 4 foot is 4, 8 foot is 3, 12 foot is 2, and if it's in the free guard zone, you get a single point.
And it'll be Team North America and Brad Jacobs to throw first. Any difference, do you think, for the men throwing this shot as compared to the women earlier, Russ?
Not this shot, I don't think. It's, maybe arguably a little better brushing, so you get a little more leeway as long as you're smart enough to be soft with the weight. And the marks become, these guys can brush as well as anybody. There's no question about it. So this is Brad's bread and butter. We noted him as a good hitter all along, but he makes a ton of these, too. That looks a hair hot, though.
And nothing yet from the Harnan brothers. EJ or Ryan, that's a 5 there. If it sits, that's 4, and it'll sit back edge. Now the 4 foot.
Four.
Okay, Marcus, T line.
On sheet B, umpire.
A little surprised at this, that they would go with Mark Nichols, Russ?
Not at all. That's his job the last 2 years is to make these draws. Now, I remember him as one of the best skilled upweight hitters in the face of the earth, especially in our two final games in Torino, Italy. He made absolutely everything. But, no, you got to go with your lead or your skip in this situation, I believe.
Yon Mead, Reed Carruthers. And out comes Jeff Stoughton, too, as well as every other fan of Canadian curling here at the Orleans Arena. This is a big drag for them. It's a huge drag for them. And the best they can do is top 12, which is 2 points.
Mark.
And she see the umpires are ready.
95.
John Schuster. 31-year-old skip from Duluth, Minnesota.
You see this stopwatch? They're doing splits, backline to hogline intervals, and it was 3.95, the time they were looking for. Looks like they're happy with it. They're just dusting it.
John Landsteiner.
Revving out pretty
Jared
good, boys.
Jared Zezel. Jeff Isaacson
hit the
tee. Calling
gotta
a
hit
line.
Got a curl. That's
okay. Little curl now, boys. Let it bend.
Yep, no. yep.
That's for four. Grab the white for five. So we'll stay on sheet C now and work our way back across the Orleans the other way. And it will be the skip of the Great Britain team in Sochi, David Murdoch, out of the Lockerbie and Curl Aberdeen clubs.
So David's inside the edge of the eight by about 3 inches. That's the tightest line we've seen. Rachel was close to that with her draws.
Line's remember, good. You don't have to hit the pin. If you're drawing to the button as a skip for Line's the last good. Rock in the game, you probably have to hit the pin. This, you have to hit a piece of the white, so you can let it over curl yep. a little bit. Make sure you're on the good path.
Real good line.
Murdoch going to appear in a third
Line's
straight
perfect.
Olympics.
Line's perfect.
6-5 Line's in Turin, 5-5 in Vancouver.
He's
and he'll score up. 5 here. So trading.
This hit.
Fives with April. Schuster in North America.
So our fourth skip, throwing the draw.
Thomas Olsrud, the 42-year-old out of Oslo, Norway, out of the familiar Snadden Curling Club.
And he took a lot of ice, mid-12-foot for this draw.
So Alman, what's his name?
Silver medal winner in Vancouver. Oh. Kevin Martin, of course, winning the gold that year. Three world bronze medals to his credit. And this is going to be sliding downhill.
Two.
So interestingly enough, he saw the Stoughton team just catch the top of the 12 for a deuce, and that's what he replies with. So they're tied.
And our second lead, Victor Schell from the Adin team.
From Karlstad, Sweden, the 28-year-old, native of Västerås in Sweden. Västerås hosted a world championship. It was 1990.
And Victor curled 100% last night in the game where they lost.
Did it without brushing, too. So five for Victor Schell to take the 1 point lead. Next up, it's the run through.
We didn't see the women have much success with this. I expect the men to throw a little more weight, maybe take tight ice and get that run back to stick in the button. That's worth the 5 points. If you get the one out on the button, but roll to the 4 foot, you get four to the 8 foot three, 12 foot two. You do have to get the one out of the house. The raised rock can roll out and you get one.
It'll be Team World to begin things, and this is 28-year-old Nicholas Adin.
I wonder why he hasn't thrown the draw on the button. This is why, because he's laser-like with some of these runbacks.
Jeff Stevens, representing Team Orem, Jordan Hurgard. And on sheet C,
Rick Lang is the coach of Team North America, three-time Canadian champion.
Team Orem, Tom Brewster.
Maybe a little bit disappointed in behind John Schuster. There is Steve Brown, three-time U.S. champion, Hall of Famer. Erica Brown's father, been involved with curling for, well, a lifetime in the USA, and he will be the coach of the U.S. Paralympic team in Sochi. Nicholas Hedin. The reigning world champion, Lindbergh, Schall. Sebastian Kraut calling line, and he'll just run this by. What's the key to this shot, Russ?
Well, you certainly have to marry up the weight and the broom, and because that's an obvious for just about any curling shot. But I think in Nicholas's case there, he throws a pretty straight out turn. So you either have to drop the speed down, which I would like to see, because then it brings your brushers into play. With these synthetic brooms, the brushers can straighten it out a little bit. So, you want to give it to the brushers. He did not do that.
Torger. Nergård throws the third stones for the Olsrud team out of Oslo. Gold medal winner with Paul Schulzen in Salt Lake City. And stick around. No. For the single. Feel almost like you've been shortchanged, Linda, when you get rid of it, didn't you?
Okay, I know.
You feel like I should get a little more than just one.
A little more valuable in a game than in this contest, isn't it?
Tom Brewster throwing the third stones for the Murdoch team. Silver medalist at the Worlds in 12 and bronze medalist a year ago. In the World Championship. Has he got something here? Oh, that is good enough. Come on.
Five points.
Four points.
Looked like it was on the line.
Yeah, to me too.
I thought they would give him the point. Really close. Is it five? Sorry. It's a four. There you go.
Well done.
Hard,
going the other way now. Jared Zezel.
Now it's going to be hard to follow because Tom Brewster really threw that inside out.
Yes.
Hard to follow that path.
It's soft.
Yeah, you get a great point, Lenny. You can really get fooled by watching the guy in front of you.
Yep. Let's go, my brother.
This one should be close.
Jeff Stoughton.
Yep. Whoa. Ah. No.
Three-time Canadian champion. Come up.
Wow. A little back. Didn't need to jump at the start.
Backed it up a bit.
Well, that's interesting because we saw that earlier. The women's play jumped that stone early, seemed to straighten it out. Almost have to wait, Russ, till it starts curling and then try to hold.
Yeah,
it.
And Jeff threw a lot of weight there, and his traditional outturn tracks pretty straight at the best of times. So it's, I thought he'd throw it softer.
Only one of the women scored in this shot. So for only two of the men, was the last one.
Ryan Pry. Bang. For five. To take a 9-5 lead. When we come back, we'll play the Rays. It's the men's singles competition on day two in Las Vegas. BMO Raptors basketball on TSN continues tonight. The Raptors at home taking on the Minnesota Timberwolves. Live coverage gets underway at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific here on TSN. Fremont Street. That's old Vegas. It's beautiful. They've got the neon lights going. Let's continue now. Men's single play, it's the Rays.
Need to push the stone into the house. The button gets you five. The 4 foot four, this is where the strategy comes in. If it's a little heavy, angle it. Get a piece of the 8 foot for three, 12 foot for two. And if you push it forward, still in play, you get a single point.
So after two of the shots, it is Brad Jacobs, Team North America, with a 9-5 lead over Nicholas Edin. And to play the Rays, the Jacobs lead Ryan Harnden, the team of the Sioux Curlers Association in Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario. Reigning Canadian champions. Went undefeated at the curling trials in Winnipeg and will wear the maple leaf in Sochi. Here they go. Got him. They got him. Oh, boy, it lost it. What happened to that stone on the way down, Russ?
I thought he was heavier than that, and then it quit curling. It turned out it was light. I don't know. I'm a little surprised. They didn't think it was light early, and of course, they had to wait for lines. It was a bad combination.
Don't forget the turn matters a little bit, too. The draw that was played earlier was on the other side, so you just don't know how much the path has been played.
Could have cooled down a little bit. Yeah. Not too many shots in a row in those areas. It's tough because you're only throwing periodically the three sheets at once.
Reed Carruthers throwing the second stones for Jeff Stoughton's team out of the Charleswood Curling Club in Winnipeg. Got to come up to the nose. Come up. Now, sit for him. Sit for him. And just
good throw, Reed.
A little too far for 3 points.
Dead on Rays, the stone takes the other turn. If you're not quite on the nose, it does go at an angle, so you can tell how well they've executed this by where it strikes the rock they're raising.
Mine's nice.
23-year-old John Landsteiner.
What's the weight at?
He throws the lead stones for the Schuster team from the Duluth, Minnesota Curling Club.
Hard says after hits here. Hard after hits. Hard hits. We got the 8 foot here.
Nope. Catch something.
Heavy.
For two.
Oh, yeah, two and two. I like that.
So the Rays struggle for the North American teams. And that's where we'll stay on sheet C. Scott Andrews from Team David Murdoch out of Lockerbie and Kerr Labberdeen.
Mine's good.
Coming in with 9 points after the first two shots.
No, it needs a curl. Needs a curl. Go if you need to, Greg. Go if you need to. Yep.
That's two. Go. That's three. Bite the red and hang on.
Oh, not a boy. Oh.
Yep.
No, he's tough. He's tough. The umpire's saying it's three. So 5 point lead for Murdoch there on John Schuster's team. Håvard Vad Pettersson throwing the lead stones. Thomas Ulsrud. In a game where both teams have really struggled so far. Ulsrud with just 3 points in the first two shots. As Stoughton's team brothers just scored a three. Oh, this looks terrific if it stops now. Needs to stop, however. Wow, he got right to the nose.
That one maybe could have been brushed a little bit. Angle it, take some of the speed off. You might have had a chance for the button.
Great point. You can even be heavy, but by taking a thinner path, hitting it thinner, you save it maybe in the edge of the four there.
Right.
So the 1 point lead remains there. Ulsrud ahead of Stoughton. World against North America. Sebastian Kraut, the third for Nicholas Edin out of Karlstad, Sweden.
Yep. Got it. Leave it okay.
Frederick Lindberg on the left. Look at Victor Schall. Talk about the pressure the brushers can put on a so low Russ. And that. Just a single point. Made contact. Kept it in the free guard zone. So that's three shots complete. And it's Jacobs leading there, 11-6. Next up, it's the hit and roll.
It's really an in-off, a roll in. The rock is just at the edge of the 12, and if you roll it into the button after hitting it, you get 5 points. If you roll into the 4 foot, it's 4. 8 foot, it's 3. 12 foot, it's 2. You have to make sure that rock does go away for the single point.
Does it matter what turn you play at this? Some people will like to go into the stone, some people off the stone, Russ.
Yeah, I think rolling into the stone is the only way to play this, and you get a lot more action. And
that is the rule. You have to play it from center.
Inside of, yeah. It would be difficult the other way.
A reminder, we're back with you this evening at 10 p.m. Eastern Time, right after Raptors basketball, and we'll have Thomas Ulsrud against Brad Jacobs. Both teams will be in Sochi.
And if you're leading like Jacobs is, you could throw softer weight at this and try to roll 12 foot, 8 foot, and get at least get points. If you're Nicholas Sedin, you want to throw a little more weight and try to roll right into that 4 foot, possibly button area.
Uh-oh.
Sorry.
Sebastian Trout.
Sorry.
Yeah, we see that. You're brushing so close to the edge on that shot. He seems to be okay.
I hit his head.
Okay. Skal det være vanlig eller noe sånt, eller? Litt mer vanlig.
Torger Nergård. For Team Ulsrud. Out of Oslo.
Whoa.
With 6 points. Yep. Leading North American Stoughton by one.
Nine.
Four. Five and hold on. Four and spin and stop. Three it is.
Just overbrushed.
Took a little bit of a jump and a little bit of a panic, and that's why the brushing happened, and that's why it overgrew. Didn't grill enough, rather. Still chuckling about that collision.
Tom Brewster.
There's that in-out release, so this ice is much tighter.
With a 12-7 lead over John Schuster.
Nothing.
As he throws here.
No.
David Murdoch said nothing, and nothing it is.
He did take out the rock, so it's
he gets
a single
point for that.
Two and out again, right, Linda? It's just the outward motion. It's hard to get it to come back.
So this is a terrific opportunity here for Schuster to get close. Down by six.
Yep.
22-year-old Jared Zezel, former U.S. champion of a couple of years ago.
Hard, boys, hard! Hard! No.
Got something?
All right, two. We got a point
for two.
Throw.
So with two shots to play, 13-9. Jeff Stoughton.
Close.
Yep.
Looking for somebody here to break out and score more than three.
Right to it. Go.
Nicholas Crowes. Right to it. Does John mean. Right to it, boys. Come on. One more turn.
Oh, boy.
Shot, Skipper. Oh,
a little bit, yeah.
I agree. And we'll grab him three. 9-8, 1 point lead for Ulsrud with two to go. It's a big opportunity here for the Jacobs team and Ryan Fry to take control against Nicholas Sedin.
Yep.
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 Hard.
Hard, guys. All the way hard. Hard.
The Hardin brothers.
Right off hard.
Trying to save it, being squeezed by the bumper as well.
Thought he was throwing it hard, he said.
That's all he's going to get is the single. So it's 1 point, yet Jacobs and North America continue to lead there, 12-6. Two shots to play. It's the men's singles on a Friday afternoon in the Continental Cup in Las Vegas. It's the skills competition of the Continental Cup on a Friday afternoon, and men's play. The world leads in two matches, North America in one. Next up, Linda, it's the double takeout.
As we saw on the women's side, this is a bit of all or none. You have to remove both the stones in the house to get any points. If you happen to stick the shooter on the button, you get the full five. If your shooter rolls to the 4 foot, you get 4, 8 foot three, 12 foot two, but you have to remove the two stones in the house to get anything.
On sheet A, it's Jacobs against Dean. Brad Jacobs and Team North America leading 12-6 as they play this double takeout. And it's E.J. Hardin, his brother Ryan on the left. Ryan Fry all on its own. One and two, and he'll get them both. He can't stick with any shooter, though. That's good for a single point.
That's so close to making it, you know, probably a quarter inch, Linda, half an inch, and it redirects the sticks.
Not far off.
John Meade, Team World leading there, 9-8. Meade throwing the third stones for Jeff Stoughton out of the Charles Wood in Winnipeg. Nichols, Carruthers, all the way down, boys. Got one, stick it, move it out. Oh, and now that shooter's going to back up and hold on. Come on back.
Curl a little bit more than I think. Good sweep, guys.
Jeff Isaacson.
Yep. Whoa. Yep. Whoa.
The third for John Schuster. One, two.
There's no turn on that thing.
And it won't go.
Sorry.
And that'll be a zero. As Schuster came in down by four to David Murdoch.
Murdoch can close him out here, Vic.
Remember now the women world team swept their singles.
Whoa!
Greg Drummond.
No.
For David Murdoch, one and two thin. So that's a big, big break for John Schuster and his team. What's happening here, Russ?
That one looked just a little heavy. It's a tough shot. It's a thin double. It's not. You see a lot of doubles made in the game, but this one, to stick it, you have to hit it extremely thin. So it's not far from a complete whiff if you're hair wide.
Now the women made two perfectly in four zeros. That's why I said it's all or none. Here we've seen a couple of singles, but nobody's made it well.
Christopher Schwab throws the second stone for the Ulsrud team out of Oslo. One, bang, hold on, spins up, come back. It'll sit there for more. So that will put Ulsrud in front. Keep him in front now by three. Nicholas Edin, the skip from Karlstad, reigning world champion. And just a big sigh as he doesn't get anything. And that's a struggle for Edin, who remains at 6 points.
Team North America 9, Team World 13.
Well, that's a huge point now for Team North America because they cannot be caught. 5 points available and up 13-6.
I think me here, Brian.
Final shot through the hole, through the port.
Has to get through the port, can't touch either guard. If you want to score, if you can get it to the button after making that port shot, you do get the full 5 points. Get it in the 4 foot, it's 4, 8 foot is 3, 12 foot is 2, but it has to go through that port and stay in play for the single point.
I know at times we've looked at this hole and thought that's pretty generous. It could be a little tighter too, maybe to make it even more difficult.
Yeah, I'd like to see a narrow report. These guys are too good. They're all the teams. The women's team made this look easy. And the key for the team that's winning, in this case, Ulsrud and Murdoch, get through the port, hit some paint. That's all they really have to do.
Victor Schell.
And this one's for pride. This isn't a lot of points for a team that just won a world championship. They'd love to finish it off with a great shot.
And we said this team was struggling, even in their Bonspiel play, Linda.
They have had a tough season so far. That's a good one.
We're trying to tune it up, and they'll finish with a 5. But that's 3 zeros out of the 6 shots. And they'll finish with 11. This is still a battle here as Team World and Ulsrud come in, leading North America and Jeff Stoughton by 3.
If we go back to the initial draws that the two players on this sheet made, Ulsrud was back 12.
Running that.
As Russ mentioned, he just needs to throw a nice draw, let them brush it into the 8 foot.
Head in. Well done.
Well, they just needed a good draw. How about this one?
Oh, that's perfect. And that'll close that out.
Let's put it on the wrong end.
And she sees the umpires are ready.
Team World here leading by 4.
Good line.
Anything in the rings?
Line's good.
Line's good.
Line's good.
Yep.
Touch for line. Line's good.
Yep.
Hard.
Yep.
Hard. Hard line.
Hard score.
Hard line.
Hard.
Hard.
Don't touch it. Oh, great brush. Wonderful brush. For 3, Drummond and Andrews. Brewster calling the line. For the 3.
Yeah, that almost touched the center guard. That would have been a 0.
That just went sideways.
Almost like a grip.
So John Schuster will close it out here for Team North America. We'll drop 2 of 3 points here. They dropped the 3 on the women's side.
Easy then. Line's good though, close. Line's good. Easy if you can. Split the tee in half.
Schuster playing with Easy Pete Fenton in Turin back in 2006 when they won a bronze medal.
Close.
And that'll stop for 4. Ooh. 16-13. The world picks up the point.
I love it.
Mark Nichols, who got it underway with the draw to the button.
Clean it.
Scoring 2.
This will make it a little easier, Ben.
Yeah, this is a hog line violation for sure. And all the way down through the hole for 5. No, the scorekeeper CC says no.
She knows the rules.
She knows the rules. No, from CC. Brad Jacobs.
In the room.
his team the most impressive so far here.
Yep. Hard line.
Against the Nicholas Hedin team that has been struggling, trying to close it out. And the Hardin brothers have him now. EJ closest to the screen, Ryan out in front, and he won't get around. So that's the first zero on the board, but it'll still be a win for North America. And their only point in the skills competition, they will win it 13-11. So after starting this afternoon's skills competition with a three-point lead, the world has now gone in front as they take five of the 6 points available this afternoon and now lead by one, 9.5 to 8.5 in the race to 30.5 to win this year's Continental Cup. So a good performance by the world in the skills here in Las Vegas.
World Financial Group Continental Cup is brought to you by World Financial Group, creating a better tomorrow for families today. WFG.
Well, so far we've seen this morning the splitting of the points in the team play, and then in singles, the world taking five of a possible six to now move in front by a point in this race to 30.5 on the second day of the Continental Cup. Tonight we'll be back with you, of course, with more men's team play as we welcome you back to the Orleans Arena on this Friday afternoon. The skills competition goes into the books. Look, and I understand. I like it because I think sometimes it shows something. I know it's not the proper game, and there's some people say, oh, poo-poo it. But the world can take something away from this, I think.
Oh, definitely. If you talk about surprises, I think Margrethe Sigfridsson, a very poor team performance earlier today, but look at the rebound. And I talked about ice rating and weight control and how bad that was this morning. They were almost perfect.
And you know, the other thing is, too, and I think you made the point, Russ, that all the focus is on them. Sometimes you can hide out here when there are other games going on, but in this one, no, it's you throwing and you're the focus of attention.
Well, yeah, especially the front ends. You know, they're never throwing when the crowd's standing there watching them complete, unless you're in a final or something. Right. So all of a sudden the place goes deadly silence. That's the worst noise of all for competitive curlers. So you have to really focus on those shots. And I thought in North America they nearly lost all six.
Now we'll be back with you tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern time after Raptors basketball. And Brad Jacobs, Thomas Ulsrud again. Two teams, 9 of the 12 here in Las Vegas will be in Sochi. So this is a preview of a game. Brad Jacobs started slowly against Nicholas Hedin yesterday. A little bit of backbiting, weren't quite sure, coming off the skins game, although all-star skins in Banff. But they got it together and they looked very good.
You talk about contrast. The big contrast about that is experience. Thomas Ulsrud has all the experience. Right. But then style of play you talk about, completely different. Jacobs has the upweight game, and I think that's going to do them very well.
Thomas Ulsrud, of course, the silver medal winner in Vancouver. Sometimes you're not quite sure what team shows up. But I bumped into him into the hallway, and I said, how are you doing? He says, I'm really looking forward to Sochi, as if somewhere inside he thinks he may have a chance there.
Oh, I think he really does. You know, obviously Jacobs has had the hot hand this winter, last winter also for that matter, but a lot of the other world teams are going to show up at the Olympics really aren't on their A game. Look at Hedin, the Scottish team struggling a little bit with Murdoch. I like Ulster's chances. I really do. He's going to be in the playoffs, I believe, for sure.
So that is tonight when we join you at 10 p.m. Eastern time. Brad Jacobs against Thomas Ulsrud. The Stoughton team already eliminated in the skills play. The final shot is the draw through the hole. You're supposed to release the stone, of course. You can't get any help from your teammates.
I don't know, extra points for the body getting through.
Yeah, it looked really good. Didn't touch the stone. No, says CC. No, that's not the way it's done. As long as there's been a Las Vegas and Nevada, there has been betting. It dates back to the early 1900s, and it is a big business. 2012, for example, $3.5 billion was bet, almost half of it on NFL, and NCAA football. Then came basketball, baseball, and hockey was in a group of others at only about 220 million. John Avello is the executive director of race and game operations here at Wynn Las Vegas. Nice to meet you, sir.
Thank you.
Why do people not want to bet on hockey?
Well, you mentioned it's in that others category, and unfortunately, the National Hockey League has shot itself in the skate with a couple of strikes through the years, and the bettors just don't want to wait for it to come back from year to year. So, unfortunately, the handle's dropped, and we move on to something else, another sport.
All right. I know you research everything. You've researched curling as well. What do you think about this weekend's Continental Cup?
Well, I believe that the world should be a slight favorite, not that it's locked in over North America, but they have the better team. They have more experience coming back. And a little home field advantage for the North America here in Las Vegas.
Well, you're right, because Nicholas Adin, of course, is the reigning world champion, and he's part of that world team. Well, you should be very proud of this facility, the Wynn Sports Book, here at Wynn's Las Vegas. John Avello, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
And maybe Mr. Avello knows something, having checked this, because if you go back, alternating years, it has been North America and Europe. Now, make a note, please, between 12 and 13, we don't want you to think that North America and the world were really bad, and they only got 37 points. They changed the point scoring structure to the 60 in North America winning. So if you follow that along, that's pretty easy. This should be a world win, is what Mr. Avello says. Through what I guess is one and two-thirds days, can we say one team is better than the other?
I don't think so. If we talk about trends, I already mentioned Margareta Sigfridsson really struggled in team play and then bounces back with the best score in singles. So it's been hard to track who is best at this event.
What's the key here, do you think? What is going to turn this around for the individual teams within a team? What is going to be the key, do you think?
Well, it's a lot more points at the end, obviously. So you've got to play really well on Sunday, but you can't get too far behind, because once you get to skins, if you're way behind, you have to start winning multiple skins in a row. Like, you have to carry over, you have to gamble a little bit more. So the team in the lead on Sunday is going to pick advantage.
And, of course, it continues tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern Time. More team play, and Brad Jacobs will be on the ice against Thomas Olsrud from Norway. As our coverage of the Continental Cup Las Vegas continues.
It's now time for today's secret word. The secret word is spinner. Go to finalend.ca and enter this word for your chance to win. World Financial Group Continental Cup is brought to you by Tim Hortons, always fresh, always great tasting coffee. By Ford, proud partner of the Canadian Curling Association for over 20 years. And by Capital One, what's in your wallet?
We'll wrap up day two of the Continental Cup here in Las Vegas, beginning tonight at 10 Eastern Time, 7 Pacific. Men's team play, Brad Jacobs against Thomas Olsrud. And after an afternoon, when the world in the skills competition picks up 5 of the 6 available points, and now they've taken a 1-point lead heading into that game tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern Time. It's been quite a couple of days so far. More to come throughout the weekend. We are in Las Vegas. Some people getting up and close and personal. It is the Continental Cup, our Canada sports leader, TSN.